Hey guys, welcome back to StockTech. Today we will be looking at the Zerodha Kite trading platform, right? So Zerodha is one of the best discount brokerages in India, and they have this beautiful trading platform known as Kite. So we will be looking at Kite today. We will be understanding all the features, from logging in to how to use those features, how to, you know, buy the stocks, sell the stocks, how to keep watch on various kinds of stocks. They have very good option for charts, for placing your buy and sell orders. They have also come up recently with GTT option, which is an amazing option. So we will be looking at all these features today, and we will be seeing this platform. Okay, before I begin, let me tell you that StockTech is a stock market training institute, and we are nowhere related to Zerodha. But majority of the people, even a lot of our students, and we personally do use Zerodha. That is why we are making a video on Zerodha. Right? So to open a trading account in Zerodha, you can visit their website, Zerodha.com, and then you can just, you know, apply for the account opening process. So they have the process, and they'll guide you through how to open the account. I think they charge a minimal charge of 300 rupees annual maintenance charge. So, right. So you can just go through it and open your DMAT account. Once you have applied for the DMAT account and all the processing is done, you will receive an email. Okay. In which you will have your login ID and your password. That is your credentials. So once you have a login ID and password, what you have to do is you just go to the Zerodha Kite. You can just Google that on Google Chrome, on all the compatible browsers. You can just type Zerodha Kites and the login page that will appear. Okay. Now you need an user ID and a password to log in, right? So now, as I told you, through your email ID, you will receive the credentials, but those will be one-time login password. So you will have to reset your login ID and login password. Then there's a PIN that you have to set it up. So I'll just be showing it to you. I'm going to Google Chrome. This is my Zerodha window over here, kite.zerodha.com, right? So let me sign in over here. I have some accounts. So this is my account. I've entered the password. After entering the password, it's going to ask for my PIN. So let me say I have my PIN, okay, which is a 6-digit numeric number. So once I have this, it says, "Hi Sumit, welcome." Okay, this is the account. Okay, this is how the platform looks like. Here you can see this is known as the watch list, the market watch. Okay, as of now, there's nothing over here. But here you have the universal search bar. Okay, above that you have Nifty 50 and Sensex. Nifty 50 is the major index for NSE, and Sensex is the index for BSE, right? So if you want to learn more about Nifty 50 and Sensex, you can also watch our video on what is Nifty, what is Sensex, how to read the index, how to understand the index. That's all totally a different video that we have made. Okay, so now setting up this watch list, right? So market watch, as you call it. Here you have this universal search bar where you can search stocks, index, everything on all the stock exchanges, right? So let me search for Reliance over here. So when I type Reliance, you can see Reliance Industries NSE, Reliance Industries BSE, NFO, etc. appears. So I am going to select Reliance Industries NSE, for example. So I have this buy, sell, chart, market depth widget, and this plus sign over here, the green color one. This is add to the list. So if I say, just click on this add to the list, now Reliance is added to my watch list. So I don't have to search it every time. Now Reliance is on my watch list. Okay, so if I want to add some more stocks like Tata Motors, right? So I'll go to Tata Motors. I'll type Tata Motors again. You have NSE, BSE, etc. I'll just select the add button, and you have Tata Motors. To add some index, like for example, I want to add Nifty Bank. So I have to type index first and then Nifty Bank, right? So you have the Nifty Bank over here. So I can add Nifty Bank. If I want to add Nifty IT, index first and then Nifty IT. Yeah, you have Nifty IT over here. So you can add almost 40 scripts in one page. You have 5 such pages. So almost you can monitor 200 stocks in your watch list. You want to take out the stocks from your list? It's simple. Just go to the stock, scroll through it, go to whichever stock you want to remove from your watch list. Just press the delete button. Gone. Okay. Along with this, you have the buy option over here. If you want to buy, you just click on the buy and the buy window opens up. We will be seeing this in detail in some time. Also, you have the sell window over here. If you want to sell something, you just click on the window and that's it. So you have this market depth here, and this is a very important feature. We have all totally a different video on this. What is market depth, how it works, and what are the buyers, sellers representing over here, okay, how the LTP is decided. So we have a completely different video on this, so you can watch that video and understand the market depth. It's very important. You guys should watch the video. Okay, what are the other options you get over here? 9 open price, today's open price, at whatever price the stock opened today morning, right? So that open price, low, how low did it go during the day, high, how high it went during the day, and close, where it closed, what was the volume. Okay, again, volume has been explained in the other video, that is the market depth video. In the same video by the name of market mechanism, we have explained all these features. You can just go through it. Last traded quantity, what is lower circuit, upper circuit, everything in depth is explained in that video. So you can watch that video to understand all these options, because in this video we are just showing how to execute the options, right? So this is your market depth, right? Beside market depth, you have the chart option. So if you click on the chart opens up, and you have all the options over here for the chart, right? So today it is displaying as the stock closed at 919.55. So if you understand candlesticks, you can learn it over here. Or we also have a video on candlesticks which you can watch. And then you have more option under which you have pin, create GTD, pop a chart, fundamentals, technical, stock reports, set alerts, etc. Coming down to fundamentals, you have something called fundamentals over here. Under the fundamentals, if you click on fundamentals, you have the company's last year's report, 1 year, price trend, okay. So what the stock has been doing for the last 1 year, you have monthly return, 1 yearly return, you have beta, you have 52 week high, 52 week low, the sector P, the stock P, and all the features you have it over here. You can also click on see detailed info and go to further detailed info about the stock from the same page. So those are the options that you have, few options that you have, okay. So this is your market watch. Now you can, you know, organize your market watch. Like for example, on market watch number 1, you can have all the industrial, the auto sectors, etc. On 2, you can organize like your banking, finance, etc. So you can organize your watch list in such a way that it's very easy for you to understand what is happening in the market. So if you open page number 1, you have the industrial stock. You can, by a look of it, you can see how the markets are functioning, how the industrial sector is working. So the first option here that we have seen is the market watch. Now going to the dashboard. The dashboard over here says Hi Sumit Equity. It is showing the equity funds available in the accounts. Here we have 263.90 rupees in the holding. Okay, commodities account 0. Holdings, we are not holding anything in this account. If you are holding something, you can see the holdings with 3 or different classifications over here. You can see current value of your holdings. You can see whatever invested. I'll be showing you this in a different account where we have some holdings. I'll show you through that. Then you have the market view over here. So you get the complete overall view. So this is your dashboard. A dashboard is basically a place where all the data is shown. Okay. Your accounts overview is known as the dashboard. The next option after the dashboard is the orders. In this option, you have the pending and the executed orders. All the orders that are displayed over here. If you have put up something to buy and it's not triggered yet, okay, so that orders, or you can see BHEL CNC 1 of 1, average price 35.2, complete. So it was a sell order. So order segment shows you whatever orders you have performed today for the day, only for the day. So whatever you buy or whatever is pending to be bought, every order that you put up in the system is displayed in the orders. Next is holdings. Under the holding segments, okay, first let me tell you, whenever you buy a stock, the stock for the day is displayed under positions. So if I take a trade today, let us say I buy Reliance today, okay, the Reliance stock will be displayed under positions. But once I keep it for more than one day, the next day it appears in holdings. So the day you buy the stock, it appears in positions, and the next day it appears in holdings. Next, you have the funds options where you know how to add the funds. You can go to add funds, you can go to withdraw funds. Please read the terms and conditions of Zerodha carefully before adding the funds, how you need to withdraw it and everything. So these are the options over here. Let me go back to dashboard. Okay, so now let us go to the buy option and understand that step by step. So let me say I want to buy the stock ONGC at 100 rupees, current market price is 99.95. let me say I want to buy the stock. I go and I just have to click on the buy button. Once I click on the buy button here, buy ONGC into one quantity. By default quantity one, you have MIS, CNC, market, limit, SL, SLM, set stop loss, target, more options, and so many other options. So let us understand this options step by step. So what is the difference between MIS and CNC? Which one should you select while buying a stock? CNC orders. The full form of CNC is cash and carry. And the CNC product is a non-intraday product used in the equity segments of BSE and NSE. Buying the stocks with your own money without any margins or leverages and with no time restrictions to sell them. Stocks bought under the CNC option are usually for taking delivery, but unlike many other platforms in Zerodha, it can also be used for BTHT trading at your own risk based on the T2 delivery settlement rule. CNC option is a non-intraday option. Here you have to buy the stocks with your own money. Okay, you don't have any time restriction to sell them. So once you buy the stocks, you can take the delivery of the stocks, you can hold the stock for one day, 10 days, a year, and so on. You don't get any margins in CNC, so it has to be bought with your own money. You can buy the stock and sell it the same day, the next day. Whereas MIS stands for marginal intraday square off. MIS orders are intraday orders and needs to be square off during the same day. If the order is not squared off by the user or converted into other order types, the risk management system of Zerodha shall automatically square off the order a few minutes before the market close. Thus, if a trader wants to strictly trade intraday, he can do so by using MIS product type. Since MIS orders are purely intraday orders, leverages are prohibited and is up to 3 to 12.5 times depending on the script. The exact leverages for every script can be found on the Zerodha margin calculator. So you can just go to the Zerodha margin calculator and exactly find out how much margins you are getting on each stock. Now let me go back over here. So if I select MIS, marginal intraday square off, okay, the stock will be sold at 315. If you don't square it off, the system will do it automatically at whatever is the current market price at that time. So if we are taking a trade with our own money, which I do recommend for the beginners, that you buy and sell only with your own money, do not use this margins options. Under this you have the market order, limit order, SL, SLM, etc. So what is a market order, what is a limit order? Okay, market order is a type of order where one wishes to buy or sell stocks immediately at the best current market price available. Okay, see what happens is when you are trading under the market option, it's like you just mentioned the quantity. For example, you have a maid at home, you want your maid to go to the market and get apples for you. So you just mention to your maid that buy 1 kg of apples. That's it. You are just mentioning the quantity. So your maid goes to the market and she buys from the nearest seller and comes back. So here in this case, it's guaranteed that you are going to get your apples, but what price you may get it is not assured. So here in this case, you can see the current market price is 54, but it is not assured that you may get the stocks at 54 itself. Okay, by the time the order gets executed, if the price jumps, okay, then your stocks will be bought at a higher rate. Yes, that does happen sometimes. Within a fraction of seconds, your orders does get executed in a second, but within fraction of seconds, there is price fluctuation sometimes. If the enough depth is available, again, you have to watch our video on market depth to understand this. Okay, so if enough depth is available, that is apples are available in the market, for sure, irrespective of the price, your maid is gonna get the apples for you. So same over here. If you put the buy order, you press the buy button, the stocks will be bought at the best available prices. Now, limit order. In limit order, along with the quantity, you are also specifying the price. So it's like giving a command to your maid, go to the market, buy 1 kg of apples at 50 rupees per kg, not higher than that. Okay, so once you place this order in the system, the stock, 100 quantities of stock will be bought maximum at 50 rupees or below that. But if the price of the stock never comes down to 50, for example, in this case, the price of the stock is at 55, as you can see, and I am placing a buy order at 50. So if the price of the stock doesn't come down to 50, your order will not be executed at all. It will lie pending, and at the end of the day, it will be cancelled. So in case of limit order, the price is guaranteed, but whether your order gets executed or not is not guaranteed. Okay, the other two options, SL and SLM, we'll be seeing it later on. These options are used for shorting. Okay, when you take short positions and you want to put a buy stop loss, SL and SLM are used. Now we are seeing the long positions. So now let us go to the Zerodha live trading platform, Kite platform.
If the markets are terribly down, today it is the effect of the coronavirus gripping around the world. Yesterday night, US markets have collapsed terribly, and today so are the Indian markets. This is terrible for the markets. The Nifty is like 4% down, okay, which can be a beginning of a big fall now. So these are my positions, and we are making some profits over here. Like, these are CNC stocks, that holding stocks that we had sold off today, and then these are the trades that we took with some small profits, not heavy trading we have done today. Okay, looking at the markets, we made somewhere around 1500 in IGL, Tata Steel and Adani Gas, etc. The markets are not doing good today, but let us concentrate on how to pick orders, how to buy the stocks, how to sell the stocks. Every order option that I have explained to you already, we will be seeing it live now. So let me pick a stock. Okay, I will pick Madhusumi. Let us pick Madhusumi. So I want to buy Madhusumi now. Now, as you can see, I'm just going to the buy option directly. This is the window that opens up. Now, I have the MIS CNC options by 100 quantities of Madhusumi. So, I've selected 100 in the market. And yeah, you can see the current market price is 103.1525. It may be bought higher, it may be bought lower. But all my 100 quantities will be bought within a second. Just look at this. It will appear here in positions now. Okay. So, now I have 100 quantities of Madhusumi at 103.5. the current price is 103.05. that's it. So 00 plus 5 rupees. So this is how I buy the stock in market order. Directly bought it under the market order, and the stocks are executed, and I have the stock right over here. Now let me try to buy the stock at 103. So I would say, if I want to buy 103, current market price is 103.55, but I want to buy at 103. So what I can do, 100 quantity at a limit price of 103. Now when I place this order, it will be lying pending in the order section. As you can see here, it is lying pending in the order section open. So only if the stock comes down to 103.00, only then the stocks will be bought. Otherwise the stocks will not be bought. You can see it's nearing my trigger price. The stock is almost at the trigger price. So as soon as it goes to 103.00, only then the stock will be bought. Now it is at 103.20, but the stock is not being bought. If I want to cancel this order, just select over here and say cancel order. So the order is cancelled now. So I have only 100 stocks of Madhusumi. So this is what's market buying and limit buying. Simple. If you want to buy at a price lower than the current market price, use limit. If you want to buy at the current market price, use market. So I want to buy India Cements, go to buy CNC, your quantity. If you want to buy limit price, like if you want to buy 96.75, if you want to buy 95, so at 95, place the order. So the order will lie pending over here. If you want to buy directly at market now, you see that the stock is not coming down to this price, you can modify it from here as well. Modify and just say market. Now it will be bought at market price.
Now let us say once you have bought the stock, now the stocks will appear in holdings or positions. So if you have the stocks in holdings, you can just say exit, and when you say exit, the sell option appears. Now when the sell option appears, you have the same options, the MIS, the CNC, the market, limit, SL and SLM. So here again, to sell using the sell orders, we have four types of sell orders: sell market, sell limit, stop loss market, stop loss limit. Sell market and sell limit are very similar to buy market and buy limit. So if you want to sell the stocks, you have 100 quantities and you are selecting CNC and market, which means the stocks will be sold at the best available rate at the current market price. But if you want to sell it at a higher price, higher than the current market price, then you use the limit option. Remember, if you want to sell it higher than the current market price, for example, current market price is 99.7, LTP is 99.7. So if you want to sell higher than 99.7, then you can use the limit option, because if the price comes to 102, then the order will be executed. If it doesn't come up to 102, the order will not be executed. Now talking about the next option, that is your SL and SLM. So to understand this, first let us understand what is a stop loss and what is a target. So stop loss is an automated order below the buy price or LTP at which you wish to sell the stock in case the stock goes in wrong direction. So basically, stop loss is a level at which you wish to sell the stock to reduce further losses. So let us understand. And target is also a level above your buy price or LTP at which you wish to sell the stocks in profit. So let us understand this. Let us assume this is the LTP, that is the last traded price of the stock, and you have taken an entry over here at the LTP. You have two options. You can either use the buy market or the buy limit. Buy market, the stocks will be immediately bought at the best available price over here at 100 rupees, and the execution of the quantity is guaranteed. But let us say you don't want to buy at 100, you want to buy at 99. So you can just place a buy limit order of 99 rupees. So the stocks will be bought at limit. So buy market and buy limit can be used for this entry. Now once you have entered the trade, let us assume that the stock starts moving down. It goes against you and starts moving down. Now at certain point, you will have to cut off your losses so that you don't make huge losses, right? So that level is known as your stop loss. So to cut off the losses below your entry price, you have the stop loss. For the stop loss, you have two options: stop loss market and stop loss limit. So you can use any of these options. I'll be explaining these options right away. And then let's say instead of coming down, your stock started going upward. So at target, you can use the sell market, sell limit. So target is the price level at which you want to sell above your entry price in profits, whereas stop loss is the level below your entry price at which you want to sell so as to minimize your losses. So let us understand the option one by one. So you know, market is to sell at the current price, limit is to sell at a price higher than the last traded price, SL and SLM are used to sell below the last traded price or your entry price. We will try to understand the two types of market orders: stop loss market and stop loss limit. So let us understand the stop loss market order first. So let us say you have taken an entry at 100, your quantity is 100, and you have taken an entry at 100. Now you see that your stock is moving down, so you have already set a stop loss. Under the SLM option, it is only going to ask you for a trigger price. Let us say you have taken an entry at 100, you set the stop loss at 95. Under the SLM option, you have given the trigger price at 95. As soon as the stock reaches the 95 levels over here, and market order, sell market order is placed into the system, and the stock gets executed under the sell market order. So whatever the price is over here, 95, whatever the closest best available price, the stocks will be sold at that price. So as soon as your trigger price is triggered, a sell market order is sent to the system and immediately executed at the market price. But in a sell limit order, stop loss limit order, you have to specify two values. That is, you have to specify the quantity first of all, and then you have to specify the trigger price as well as the limit price. So let me explain this over here. Let us assume the same scenario where you have taken a entry at 100 rupees. Now the trade goes against you and it's going down. So now you have to give a range. You have given a range of 97 to 95. In a stop loss limit order, while entering the order, two types of prices are required to be entered: the trigger price and the limit order price. Without entering both these prices, the order will not be accepted. To continue with the above example, if one wishes to sell the securities till 95, after it crosses 97, then this option can be used. For example, as soon as the trigger price is triggered over here, a limit order till 95, limit, you have to mention the limit order price, so the stocks will be sold between 97 to 95. So that's your stop loss limit order. In the stop loss market order, at the trigger price, the stocks will be sold off at market price, so selling of the stock is assured. But whereas in a stop loss limit order, if the stock goes below the limit level, then your order will not be executed. So now let us
put a stop loss for this. So what is the stop loss? I want to sell the stock. If it goes below 100, I want to sell the stock. So I'm going to select exit. Once I select exit, I will go to SLM, that is stop loss market, and whatever is my stop loss, like 100, okay, 100, right? So I will just say yes, and SLM, direct SLM. I've told you what is the difference between limit or SL and SLM. So we are placing an SLM, so only the trigger price. So it's all set. So if the stock goes down to 100, it will be automatically sold off, right? Now, if you want to modify your stop loss, you have to go to orders and then go to Madasumi, and I can say modify. Okay, the stock has gone to, now let us assume 105. So I want to put a stop loss higher of 102. So I'll say modify. So like this, we can also keep modifying the stop loss. But if I want to put a stop loss, let me cancel this stop loss first. You cannot put two stop losses on the same stock. So now let a stop loss limit order. So if I want to put a stop loss limit order, I'll go to exit. We will go to SL. Now it is asking for the price and the trigger price. Let us assume you want to sell the stock at 100. The trigger price should be something higher than your price. So as soon as the stock touches the trigger price, a limit order of 100 rupees will be sent to the market, limit sell. So this is when you want to put the stop loss. Now let us assume you have sufficient profits and you want to sell the stock right away. So to sell the stock right away, you can go to exit and just select market, sell in market. So here the stock is automatically sold off. Now let us assume we have a stock. So let me randomly buy a stock. Let me buy India Cement, CNC, market or limit. So I'm going to buy the stock in market. So one quantity. So I have this one stock over here, 95.75, right? So I have this one stock over here. Now I want to sell it higher than the current price. So it's like I want to set a target. 95.75 is the current price. I want to sell it at 97. So I'll go to exit. I will go to limit. Okay. And I will say 97. And then I will say sell. So again, an order is pending over here on India Cements. So now if India Cement comes to 97, it will be sold off. So remember one thing. If you buy a stock, you have two options to buy it. You can buy it in market, you can buy it in limit. Now, once you have bought the stock, if you want to sell it, you can sell it in market, that is currently at whatever price it is, or if you want to sell higher than the current market price, then you will set it in limit. But if you want to put a stop loss that is lower than the current market price, then you can use SL or SLM. So these are the few options that we use when buying and selling the stocks.
Moving on, additional features, that is bracket orders, cover orders, aftermarket orders, etc. So here you have a more option window. When you go to Zerodha, And when you click on this buy option, you have this more options window over here. So when you click on the more options, you have regular, bracket order, cover order, AMO, etc. Okay, let me explain this in simple words. A regular order, as you saw, our regular market buy, limit buy, etc. But what is a bracket order? A bracket order is basically three orders into one. So here, to specify the quantity, you have to specify the price at which you want to buy. Okay, you have to specify the stop loss in absolutes. So for example, if I am buying the stock, let us say I want to buy it at 99, so it's a limit order now because the current market price is at 99.95, but I'm buying it under 99. My stop loss is 10 rupees. Absolute values you have to mention over here. Price, buy price would be 99, your stop loss would be 89. Target is 20 rupees, so that would be your 119 would be your target. Okay, and then there is another option for trailing stop loss. So let us say 2 rupees is my trailing stop loss. Now what happens, this when I press the buy option, the buy will be executed, the stop loss will be set, and the target also will be set. So your buying price would be 99, your target stop loss would be 89, target would be 119. What this trailing stop loss will do, for example, if my stock moves from 99 to 102, my stop loss would move from 89 to 91. Okay, so this is your bracket order. Entry price, stop loss, target, and trailing all in one. Going to the cover order, cover order is an option to enter the stock with the stop loss in the same order panel. Okay, so for example, here I want to buy the stock at 99 and my stop loss is 98. So I am taking an option where I am buying the stock at 100. My entry price is a limit order of 99 and stop loss trigger price of 98. Or if I go for market under a cover order, say it's not asking me the price, it will be bought at 99.95 or whatever is the closest price available. But I can just mention the stop loss. This orders, that is your bracket order and cover order, give you the very high margins and leverages. The highest margins provided are under cover orders. Then you also have the aftermarket orders. This option is used to place orders between 3:30 to 9:15. So for people who could not monitor the markets during the working hours, that is 9:15 to 3:30, due to their busy schedule, can place orders under this mechanism. Now, recently they have introduced a very new and a very advanced feature known as GTT. A lot of people, especially the working professional, always had an issue where they feel that since due to the working hours, they are not able to monitor stocks. If they are buying the stocks, they are not able to sell them. They forget sometimes to put their stop losses, because under the normal stop loss orders, you have to put a stop loss on everyday basis. So because of all these issues, a lot of people make losses. So now Zerodha has come up with a very good option known as the GTT. So GTT stands for Good Till Triggered. The Good Till Triggered feature, or GTT feature, is a feature which allows you to set a certain trigger price, certain trigger condition, such that as and when such trigger conditions are met, a limit order as per the trigger condition set by you would be placed on the exchange and is valid for the next 365 days. Okay, there is no actual order placed under the GTT. You give a trigger price and you give a limit price. So as soon as the trigger price is triggered, an order would be sent to the exchange and it would be executed. GTT can be used only for CNC type orders, that is only on equity cash segment in NSE and BSE. The price selected by you as a trigger price for stock scripts having a market price greater than rupees 50 must be 0.5% away from the current market price of the stock. So let us say it's 100 rupees stock, so your trigger price, that is your GTT, should be at least 50 paise away from the current price. The price selected by you as a trigger price for stock scripts having a market price lesser than rupees 50 must be 25 paise away from the current market price of the stock. Yes, so any stock below rupees 50, you can set a trigger, but 25 paise away from the current market price. There are two types of GTT orders, single trigger and OCO.
Now let us see the GTT option. Okay, so first we will see the GTT option for the buy side, and then we will see the GTT option for the sell side. So let us say we want to put a GTT buy on the stock called Sun Pharma. Okay, so I want to buy the stock. Currently the stock is at 371, but I want to buy the stock when it comes down to 360, or I want to buy the stock when it goes to 380. Okay, as you know, GTT orders will lie pending for 1 year. As soon as it is triggered, a limit order will be sent. So let me assume I want to buy Sun Pharma if it comes down to 360. So I open the chart, I have done some analysis, you know, we follow the demand and supply analysis. According to the demand and supply analysis, we had taken the trade yesterday itself. Okay, so now I want to take the trade in Sun Pharma around somewhere here, 360 levels, right? If it comes down currently at 371 levels, if it comes down to 360, I want to buy the stock. Or our strategy may be saying only buy the stock if it crosses 390. So in either cases you have to wait and buy, but you cannot be active in front of the system always, right? So here you can just say create GTT buy stock at 360. So you have to enter your quantities over here. Quantity, I'll explain the trigger in a minute. Quantities over here, and let us say you want to buy at 360. So this is your price, actual price, this is your quantity. So this is your limit order. Remember the limit order? Yes, it is to ask for quantity and it used to ask for price. So this is your limit order. See here, limit order. But what we are doing is, when should this limit order be activated? Okay, so to put GTT orders, your funds may be or may not be blocked all the time. Only when the trigger is activated, then the orders goes to the system and then those funds are blocked. So for example, my trigger is 362. So only when the stock reaches 362, then this limit order of 360 will be sent to the exchange, and only then your funds are withheld. I'll say I agree and I place the order. So my order is already created. So when the stock comes down at 362, a buy order of 360 is sent to the system and the stocks will be bought. But let me assume that I am actually planning to buy higher. So now placing the trigger changes. Let me say I want to buy at 390. I want to buy 100 stocks. But remember, when you want to buy higher, so your limit price is 390, but your trigger should be below 390, because when the stock is going up, first it will hit 388, right? So once it hits 388, a buy order of 390 will be sent to the system. So if you are buying below the current market price, then trigger price will be higher than the price. But if you are buying above the current market price, like at 390, then the trigger price will be lower than the buy price. So this is your buy price. So my trigger price would be 388. I can just place the order. So when you go to orders and you go to GTT, under the GTT option, you have both the orders placed. If you want to modify it, you can modify it. If you want to delete it, you can just simply delete it. Got it?
So let me clear this, that you cannot put a buy order and a stop loss order at the same time under the GTD option. You cannot do that. You have to first put a buy order. When your buy order gets executed and you already have the stocks with you, either in your positions or your holdings, only then you can put a GTD sell order. So when you have the stocks already, for example, I have Madhusumi over here, I have Idea over here, only when I am holding the stocks in my positions or in my holdings, only then I can put a sell GTT to it. Many of you all have a confusion that we can put a buy option and a stop loss option at the same time. No, that cannot be done. So now when I'm trying to sell this, so you have two options over here. Buy, sell. Now we are trying to create a sell GTD. Under the sell option, you have a single option or you have the OCO. Under the single option, you can set one limit order where you want to sell the stock. This can be your stop loss, that is below your entry price, or it can be above your entry price. This is important to understand. So let us see this in a bit detail. So you have let's say bought the stocks at 62.5, that's your entry price. This is your entry price at 62.5. This is your entry price. Okay, but currently the stock is somewhere around 63.5. This is the CMP of the stock, the current market price of the stock. Now, when you are trying to sell the stock, you have two options. You can either put a target using the single GTT, single cell GTT, you can put a target, okay, or you can put a stop loss, either of the two. Let me say your target is around 70 rupees, or your stop loss, let me say it's 55 rupees. So your stop loss is 55, your target is 70. Now, when you are putting an order under the GTT, let me show you this. So here, when I go and I say create a GTT, sell GTT single. So what do you want to enter? Do you want to enter your target or do you want to enter your stop loss? So let me say I want to enter my target. So my target price is 70. My quantity is whatever quantity I have. And the trigger price. So what is a trigger price? A trigger price is a price which, when triggered, sends a limit order to the system. So it's pretty obvious that your trigger price should be somewhere over here. Like your trigger price should be 68. Why it should be 68? Because when 68 is triggered, sell order of 70, limit order of sell at 70 is sent to the system. Getting my point? But in case you are setting a stop loss before reaching 55, the stock is going to reach 57, 58, 56. So your trigger price should always be higher than the stop loss. While setting your target, your trigger price should always be lower than the target price. While setting your stop loss, your trigger price should always be higher than the stop loss price. Let us say we are trying to set a target at 70, so my trigger price will be 68, because once the stock starts going up, it will hit 68 first. When it hits 68, a limit order of sell at 70 is sent to the system. But let me say I'm setting a stop loss of 55. Okay, so now my trigger price should be higher than 55, that is 57. So when the stock starts going down, it will trigger 57 first, and once it triggers 57, then a stop loss limit order of 55 is sent to the system, and if it reaches the 55, it will be sold off. Now you have another option where you can set the target as well as you can set the stop loss. So that's under sell and that's under OCO. One cancels the other. Either the stop loss or the target order is placed when the last traded price crosses the respective triggers. Used to set targets and stop loss for stock holdings. So in this order, you can set a stop loss and a target at the same time. So you have to give four values over here. Remember, five in fact. First is your quantity. So in this, you give your quantity. Okay. And then you will give the target trigger price, target trigger and target price. And you will also give the stop loss trigger and your stop loss price. So once you buy the stock, you put a target, you put a stop loss, and you forget the stock. The stock either goes to your stop loss or the stock either goes to your target. But you can also keep modifying the stock. Let us assume the stock starts going up. From 55, you can increase your stop loss to 60, to 62, to 64. As the stock goes up, you can also trail your stop loss and keep following the stock. But trailing has to be done manually. It won't happen automatically. Okay, but let us see how to set the OCO order. So see here, it is mentioning the stop loss and it is mentioning the target. So my current entry into the stock is at 62. Concentrate on this. Okay, first let me put a limit order. This is a normal limit order like the other one. So let us say it's 55 is my stop loss. Quantity is 250. So obviously for target also quantity is going to be 250. And price is, target price is 70. Now I have to give the triggers. While giving the trigger for the stop loss, when the stock goes down, it will hit 56 first or 55 first. So obviously 56, 57 first. So I should give a trigger price higher than the stop loss, because once the stock is coming down, it will hit the trigger price. Only then a limit order of 55 will be sent to the system. But when the stock is going up, it will hit 50, 68, 69 first. So here, when you are setting the target, your trigger should be lower than the price. So now for Madhusumi, I have stop loss, I have trigger, I just say place and the order is placed. I can go to orders, I can go to GTT, and you can see it's in the off market also. You can place an order. You have the OCO sell order with a trigger of 57 and with the target trigger of 68. Now let us assume your stock from 63 goes to 64. You want to modify. You are very confident that the stock can go even higher, but you want to play safe as well. So what I'll do, when the stock goes higher, I'll increase the target as well as increase the stop loss. So you can keep modifying as well. So these are your orders. But under the GTT orders, go to Zerodha and read the terms carefully, because there are some terms that you have to keep a watch on. For example, let us say you have placed a stop loss and that day the stock reached 57, which is your trigger, stop loss trigger. So the stock reached 57 over here, and now a limit order of 55, stop loss price 55, was sent to the system. But that particular day, the stock never came down to 55. So what happens? Your GTT already got triggered. A 55 stop loss order was sent to the system, and it was pending in the system. Now at the end of the day, this order also gets cancelled. So in case your stock, your GTT order gets triggered, but the limit price is not met, the order will not be executed. And what happens in cases of gap ups, gap downs, when the stock opens gap down, you go through the term, the conditions that Zerodha has, read through it, and you can trade in the Zerodha platform. Hope this video helps you. If you want to open a Demat account, the link is provided in the description. Okay, you can click the link and you can open your Demat account in Zerodha. We also have a free WhatsApp group link in description for Stock Tech group, where you can learn about the stock market. You will be educated about the stock market, and it is a completely free group. There are no charges. For more details, you can visit our website www.stocktech.in or call or WhatsApp us on 7829295555. Before opening your account with Zerodha and going forward with the trading, please go through the terms and conditions. Whatever we have explained in this video is best as per our knowledge. We might have made some mistakes in explaining some points, but that is again to the best of our understanding. Stock market investments are subjected to market risk. Please consult your financial advisor for any investment decisions. StockTech is neither a partner nor an associate with Zerodha. We are in no way responsible for any issues that you face on their platforms. Okay, this video was made on demand of our students and members, and we are not responsible for any profits or any loss you make on the trading platform due to any issues. So before opening your account, go through the terms, conditions, how the platform works, how the order execution works, and everything thoroughly, and then go forward. Thank you for watching this video. Keep watching, keep sharing, or do subscribe to our YouTube channel, and see you until next time. Thank you.